Okay, good morning students. Next chemical properties in alkanes is fourth one, addition of sulfuric acid. Addition of sulfuric acid, fourth addition reaction to alkenes. Alkenes addition, we are discussing alkenes addition reactions. Fourth addition reaction is addition of sulfuric acid to alkene. Let us take alkene, that is ethene. This is ethene. When ethene undergo addition reaction with sulfuric acid, that is OHS double bond OH. This is sulfuric acid. Forms ethyl hydrogen sulfate. One of the hydrogen is added to double bond, so it becomes ethyl CH3 CH2 O S double bond O S double bond O OH. It become ethyl hydrogen sulfate. Ethyl hydrogen sulfate. Simple. When ethene undergo addition reaction with sulfuric acid, forms ethyl hydrogen sulfate. One of the hydrogen added to double bond, and remaining part is added to another carbon. So ethene gives addition product with sulfuric acid is ethyl hydrogen sulfate. If you take propene, CH3 CH double bond CH2, when propene undergo addition reaction with sulfuric acid, one of the hydrogen added to this carbon, and remaining part is added to, this is H plus O minus. It becomes propene. Upon addition reaction with sulfuric acid, forms propyl hydrogen sulfate, that is CH3 CH3 O S double bond O OH. So this is propyl hydrogen sulfate. Okay, the addition reaction of sulfuric acid to alkene forms respective alkyl hydrogen sulfate. If it is ethene, ethyl hydrogen sulfate. If it is propene, it becomes propyl hydrogen sulfate. Next addition reaction, addition of water. Next addition of water. Simple. When water is added to alkene, the product is, if you take 2-methyl propene upon addition with water, forms 2-methyl propene. 1, 2, 3. Methyl group at second position. 2-methyl propene undergo addition with water, forms 2-methyl. This is 1, 2, 3. 2-methyl propane 2-ol. 2-methyl propane, 1, 2, 3 carbons, OH. Methyl group at second position and OH also at second position. 2-methyl propane 2-ol. So this is an addition of water to alkene, that is propene. Okay, next addition. Next important reaction, next important chemical reaction in alkene is oxidation of alkenes. वेरी 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 इंपॉर्टेंट, ऑक्सीडेशन, ऑक्सीडेशन ऑफ ऑल कीट्स, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रिएक्शन इज ऑक्सीडेशन ऑफ ऑल कीट्स. सिंपल, when alkenes undergo oxidation with the reagent is very important. When alkene, this is ethene, when alkene undergo oxidation with air in presence of cold alkaline, cold dilute, cold dilute aqueous KMnO4 forms 1,2-diols, that is glycol, CH2CH2OH. This is 1,2 ethane 1,2-diol, ethane 1,2-diol. This is first carbon, second carbon. Okay, ethane 1,2-diol. Simple. When ethene undergo oxidation in presence of water with cold dilute aqueous KMnO4. Okay, cold dilute aqueous KMnO4 gives diols, or this is glycol. This is glycol. Okay, it forms 1,2-diols. 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 2 OH groups. That's why diols. Okay, 2 OH groups, diols. Here, cold dilute aqueous KMnO4 is called Baer's reagent. Baer's reagent, very, very important. This cold dilute aqueous KMnO4 is called Baer's reagent. Simple. When alkene undergo oxidation with Baer's reagent, in presence of Baer's reagent, forms 1,2-diols. Here, this is decolorization of this alkaline KMnO4 is a test for unsaturation. Very, very important. Means unsaturation test is determined by this KMnO4, that is Baer's reagent. Cold dilute aqueous KMnO4 is called Baer's reagent. This cold dilute aqueous KMnO4 is called as Baer's reagent. Baer's test is a test for unsaturation. Means if a compound contains double bond or unsaturation, double bond or triple bond, it is determined by test with Baer's reagent, that is KMnO4. KMnO4, that is Baer test, is a test for unsaturation. Means presence of unsaturation can be determined by KMnO4, Baer's test. Next, if it is unsymmetrical alkene, that is CH double bond CH2. Undergo oxidation with KMnO4. This KMnO4 forms diols. This is propene. Okay, propene undergo oxidation in presence of cold dilute KMnO4 forms 1,2 diol. Okay, propane 1,2 diol. This is a Baer's test. Baer's test is used for unsaturation. Next, in this oxidation, second point, acidic KMnO4 means KMnO4, potassium permanganate in acidic medium, oxidizes acidic KMnO4, oxidizes alkenes to ketones or acids. Ketones are acids. Okay, acidic KMnO4. KMnO4 in acidic medium oxidizes alkenes to ketones or acids. Here, acidic KMnO4 oxidizes alkenes to ketones or acids. Let us take 2-methyl propene. This 2-methyl propene. This is 2-methyl propene. 2-methyl propene undergo oxidation with acidic KMnO4. Acidic KMnO4 oxidizes this as ketone plus CO2 plus H2O. Okay, this 2-methyl propene undergo oxidation with acidic KMnO4 forms acetone plus CO2. Acetone plus CO2. This is a ketone, a type of ketone. Okay, next. When 2-butene undergo oxidation with acidic KMnO4, 2-butene, this is 2-butene, 2-butene undergo oxidation with acidic KMnO4 forms acids. This double bond become COH, COH and COH. That is CH3COOH. It become 2-butene become acidic acid or ethanoic acid, acetic acid. Simple. Acidic KMnO4 oxidizes alkene to ketone or alkene to acids. Acids group here, ketone group. C double bond is a ketone group. Very important, very, very important. This acidic KMnO4 oxidizes alkene to ketone or alkene to acids. Depends upon substituents. Okay? So this is oxidation, important reaction, oxidation reaction of alkenes. Next, ozonolysis. Next reaction is ozonolysis. Next, ozonolysis means addition of ozone to alkenes. Ozonolysis means addition of ozone. What is ozonolysis? Addition of ozone to alkenes. Simple. When propene undergo ozonolysis, when ozone is added to alkene or propene, forms ozonide. It forms ozonide. These three oxygen atoms attached to double bond. It forms a cyclic ozonide, a cyclic ring, that is ozonide. So this is a ozonide. Ozonide is a intermediate cyclic ring. Simple. When propene undergo addition reaction to ozone or propene undergo ozonolysis, forms intermediate, that is ozonide. Ozonide is a cyclic intermediate product. This ozonide upon hydrolysis in presence of zinc forms products. Product is CH3CHO plus CH2O or HCHO. This is ethanol. This is methanol. Ethanol and methanol are the final product. Simple. When alkene undergo ozonolysis, forms an intermediate, that is ozonide. Ozonide is a cyclic intermediate compound. This ozonate upon hydrolysis in presence of zinc forms respective final products. If another example, CH3 double bond CH2. Okay, what is this compound? 1, 2, 3. 2-methyl propene undergo ozonolysis. This 3 oxygen bond forms react with this ozone forms bond with alkene, forms ozonide. Okay, this 2-methyl propene forms ozonide with ozone. This is ozonide. Ozonide is a intermediate product. This ozonide upon hydrolysis with zinc forms acetone plus methanol. CH3 C double bond O CH3 plus CH2O. This is acetone. This is methanol. Okay, simple. When 2-methyl propane undergo ozonolysis forms a ozonide. This ozonide upon hydrolysis in presence of zinc forms acetone plus methanol. This is an ozonolysis reaction. The importance of ozonolysis reaction is it is a very important reaction, because this reaction is used to determine the position of double bonds in alkene. Very important. The position of double bonds, position where actually a double bond is present in an alkene, in a given alkene. The position of double bond in alkene can be determined by using which reaction? Ozonolysis reaction. That's why ozonolysis is very important. Ozonolysis is a test for determination of position of the, identification of the position of the double bond in alkene. So oxidation and ozonolysis. Oxidation for test for unsaturation. Ozonolysis is a test for position of double bonds in alkene. And last, polymerization. Last chemical reactions of alkene is polymerization. Okay, last chemical reactions of alkene is polymerization. What is polymerization? A number of monomer units means a combination of a smaller molecules forms a bigger molecule is called polymer. Number of monomers gives polymer. A combination of number of monomers is called polymer. Okay, let us take example. Ethylene, number of ethylene molecules, A means number of ethylene molecules at high temperature and pressure at a given catalyst, in presence of catalyst, forms ethylene. This is ethene. Number of ethene molecules at high temperature and pressure in presence of catalyst forms polyethene. It forms polyethene. Ethene upon polymerization forms polyethene. Okay, next, if it is propene, number of propene at high temperature and pressure, in presence of catalyst फॉर्म्स पॉलीप्रोपिलीन। पॉली प्रोपलीन, पॉली प्रोपलीन। ओके सिंपल। व्हेन इथीन, नंबर ऑफ इथीन मॉलिक्यूल्स एट हाई टेम्परेचर प्रेशर प्रेजेंस ऑफ कैटलिस्ट फॉर्म्स पॉलीथीन। प्रोपीन एट हाई टेम्परेचर एंड प्रेशर इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ कैटलिस्ट फॉर्म्स पॉली प्रोपलीन। दिस पॉली इथिलीन एंड पॉली प्रोपलीन आर पॉलीमर्स ऑफ इथीन एंड प्रोपीन। व्हाट आर द यूजेस ऑफ polymers? The uses of polymer is, these polymers are used to make toys and buckets and various things. These polymers are used to make toys, buckets, many other things. So the use of polymers is very, very important. So this is the chemical reactions of alkene. With this alkene's concept is completed. Thank you.